JTL students, thank you very much for being here today as well as our special guests. As you know, we typically gather together to engage in celebrations, fun, and perhaps even craziness. However, today is not one of those days. Today is a day that I need your utmost attention and very best behavior. During our time together this morning, we will acknowledge our American veterans. Our American veterans and current service members are the true heroes of our country. These men and women who have fought and served our country are directly responsible for the freedoms and liberties we have today. It is an honor and a privilege to work with JTL staff members who have served our great country. I'm also honored to have a father, grandfather, grandmother who served our country, as well as a brother who is currently serving in our Air Force. When I think of a hero, the first people to come to mind are our veterans. Thank you to all who have served and who are serving the greatest country in the world. Today's ceremony is a salute to our American heroes. Thank you, veterans. At this time, I'd like to introduce our hosts, Noah McAllister and Maya Glendian.
Thank you, Principal Lenhart. Good morning and welcome to our celebration of veterans. My name is Nolan McAllister and I'm an 8th grade student on the 8th Bridge team. I am also involved in media design, Good Morning JTL, and JHS, and I play on the girls soccer and basketball team here in JTL.
Hello, I am Maya Glenian. I am an 8th grade student on the 8th Bridge team. I am involved in Good Morning JTL media design class. I'm on the field hockey and soccer team here at JTL, and I play in our 8th grade symphonic band. We are here today to show our patriotism and our pride in our country. At this time, please follow me as we recite our Pledge of Allegiance. Please stand.
When it is sung, it brings out the love for one's country and reminds us what being patriotic is all about. The hope is that when the time has come and the country needs you, the national anthem will be a reminder of what is at stake and what one's duty is to their country. I'd like to welcome our 7th and 8th grade band, directed by Mr. Delvecchio, and our 7th and 8th grade choir, directed by Mr. Mingle. Please stay standing for a respectful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner.
Started. In this short video clip, you will learn some of the history behind and why it is so important that we celebrate it, please enjoy the short movie titled JTL Celebrates Veterans Day.
Soldiers from wars both old and new march down city streets. Flags hang from homes, businesses, even car antennas. Ceremonies remember those who dutifully served their nation. It's Veterans Day, or Remembrance Day, as it's known in much of the world. A time to honor members of the armed forces. And it all began in a railroad car with a document to end the war, to end all wars. World War I, also known as the Great War, shocked the global community with its unprecedented toll in human life. Untold millions were killed. Germany was running low on manpower and supplies, so they agreed to sign an armistice, or truce, in the French commander Ferdinand Foch's private rail car. On the 11th hour, on the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918, all was quiet on the Western Front. The fighting had ended. Exactly 1 year later, President Woodrow Wilson decreed that Americans should observe a moment of silence at 11 a.m. to remember the armistice and to embrace the peace. Other Allied nations commemorated the peaceful anniversary as well. In England and Canada, citizens wore paper poppies. Poppies had become a symbol of the armistice. The poem Flanders Field described a one-time battlefield. In Flanders Field, the poppies blow between the crosses row on row. In America, the nation's first unknown soldier was laid to rest at Arlington National Cemetery on Armistice Day, 1921. He was a casualty of the Great War. Since that first memorial, other unknown soldiers from America's wars have been interred in the tomb. And it's become tradition for the president or one of his representatives to lay a wreath on the monument every November 11th. A resolution was passed in 1926 inviting all Americans to remember Armistice Day and the soldiers who fought so hard for peace. The idea caught on. By 1938, the day was marked with so many ceremonies and parades, Congress made it a legal holiday, giving people the day off work. After World War II and the Korean War, Americans wanted to open up the holiday to include not just World War I veterans, but all who served in combat. In 1954, President Dwight Eisenhower, a World War II vet himself, legally changed the U.S. Armistice Day to Veterans Day, honoring those who served in all American wars. For a brief time, starting in 1971, Congress moved the holiday to the fourth Monday in October, giving Americans a three-day weekend. But most people rejected the idea. The traditional date of November 11th, the anniversary of the Great War's ceasefire, was too historically important to forget. President Ford reversed the law in 1975, returning Veterans Day back to its rightful date. Over the decades, the holiday has changed with the times. Originally, it was a call for world peace. Then, in the U.S., it became a day to remember war veterans. Today, Veterans Day is set aside to honor not just those who served in war, but also those who have served their nation in peace.
Thank you, Mrs. Hill, for providing that informative video about our celebration today. We are fortunate to have several faculty members who have served in the military here to teach us each day. I would like to welcome Mr. Jason Lee to the stage. He was a Lance Corporal in the Marines and today serves as a social studies teacher on the 8th grade OT.
General orders 1-3, to take charge of this post and all government property in view, to walk my post in a military manner, keeping always on the alert and observing everything that takes place within sight and sound, report all violations of orders I am instructed to enforce. Good morning. My name is Mr. Lee, formerly Lance Corporal. I currently teach 8th grade social studies here at JTL in the summer of 1990. Our military forces were called upon for Operation Desert Storm. I talked with my parents that night and said, I will enjoy what then serve my country, just as my grandfather did in World War II. He was my hero, and I wanted to be like him. My MOS, or job, was expeditionary security. This is a dedicated security unit of the United States Marine Corps, and it provides security forces to guard high-value naval installations, most notably those containing nuclear weapons and submarines. The Marine Corps Code of Esprit de Corps, Spirit of the Body, has long held a great tradition of camaraderie among Marines that have served and are currently serving. For once a Marine, always a Marine. Today is the Marine Corps birthday, and every Marine celebrates. We are 248 years old. The motto, Semper Fi, truly echoes in my mind every day. Always faithful. Faithful to yourself, your country, your core, your family, your friends, your job, everything in life. Always give 100% of yourself to any task, and always hold your head up high no matter what obstacle you face. Thank you.
The military branches of service require many different types of educated individuals to be successful. So coming up to speak about her military service in the Navy is Miss Mary Jo Fisher.
The soldiers greet. I am an American soldier. I am a warrior. Good morning. My name is Ms. Schembeck, formerly Sergeant Schembeck. I currently teach 8th grade math here at JTL. I always wanted to be a teacher, but when I was in 8th grade, something changed. When I was in 8th grade, on September 11th, 2001, my goals broadened. There's a great tragedy that struck our nation, and with family in the city, I wanted to help and serve. I still wanted to teach, though, while serving, so that led me to join the Pennsylvania Army National Guard. I first went to Fort Sill, Oklahoma for basic combat training, where I learned basic soldier tasks that helped me instill leadership skills, Army values, and core beliefs as stated within the Soldier's Creed that I just said. After that, I went to Fort Huachuca, Arizona, which I loved, for advanced independent training, individualized training, focusing on my MOS, which was a 35 box. My MOS, or job, was an intel analyst, where I gathered information from multiple sources and presented it in a manner that would help support the mission. I was even able to return to Arizona for specialized training on equipment that helped support missions by using satellites on top of a Humvee to provide intelligence systems and communications to my unit in the middle of a field, in the middle of the woods, which was pretty cool. And I really enjoyed that. Just like Ms. Fisher said, there was a lot of fun that was had, there was a lot of experiences that I enjoyed, and I'm so grateful for that opportunity that I was given and took advantage of it. I'm grateful for the people that I've met and the many experiences I had while serving, which allowed me to learn and grow as a soldier and as a person. No matter where life takes you, always give it your all. Learn from every experience, and you will do great things. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Conner. Today, I have the privilege of introducing our guest speaker, First Sergeant Marley Bogomil. She's an active duty member of the Pennsylvania Army National Guard and manages a medical clinic that performs physicals for aviators in Fort Indiantown Gap, Pennsylvania. Please welcome to the stage First Sergeant Marley Bogomil.
For 18 years now. I realize that is longer than you've all been alive. So I, like Ms. Fisher, originally joined the National Guard to help pay for my last 2 years of college. But after I joined the National Guard, I developed a true love for the military. So I did finish my four-year degree in December of 2010, but I started full-time for the Pennsylvania Army National Guard in March of 2011. Since then, I've held many different jobs, including intelligence analyst, recruiter, operations, administrative work, combat medicine, training, and I even had the good timing and fortune to become one of the handful of the first enlisted females to become infantry qualified. Thank you. During that time, I've been to Egypt, Israel, Germany, and all over the U.S. But truthfully, my favorite missions are the ones that the National Guard does here at home. So in addition to our federal mission to fight and win our nation's wars, the National Guard has a special mission. The governor of the state, during times of emergency, can activate the National Guard to help you here in your communities. So you may have seen us around during snowstorms, floods, hurricanes, even the COVID-19 pandemic. The military has been a huge part of my life. I've forged unbreakable friendships. I've grown through the ranks, honed my leadership skills, had the opportunity to try out multiple different jobs, and I continue to challenge myself in new ways every day. I'd like to close with a thanks to your teachers, your family members, and your friends for their service. And lastly, to those of you in the crowd that are considering carrying the torch on when I hang this uniform up and retire, thank you for continuing to protect us.
And thank you to all of our faculty who have served our country. My Country, 'Tis of Thee, also known as Simply America, is an American patriotic song, the lyrics of which were written by Samuel Francis Smith in 1831. The song served as one of the de facto national anthems of the United States before the adoption of the Star Spangled Banner as the official U.S. national anthem in 1931. The melody used is adopted from the national anthem of the United Kingdom, which is titled God Save the King. Today, our band will play two verses of this song. The first in unison, which is a simpler version, followed by the chorale version, which has many more robust parts. Please welcome Mission Olympia back to the stage for the JTL band's rendition of America, My Country, Sis of Thee.
Sergeant Schembeck served as an intel analyst in the PA Army National Guard. Ms. Schembeck teaches 8th grade math at JTL.
First Sergeant Marley Bogomil conducting a training exercise for future combat medics in the Army at Fort Indiantown Gap, PA. She is family of Ms. Schembeck.
Retired Air Force Lieutenant Colonel Deidre Gurry is the sister of Aaron Weiss, 6th grade math teacher.
Ms. Knob is the father of English teacher Mrs. Petra. He served in the Korean War as a mechanic and was the most patriotic man she has ever known.
Army Sergeant First Class Leonard Nisavacha served in the Korean War 1951 through 1952. He is the father of Security Guard Carol Pinto.
Sergeant Zachary Taylor, National Guard, has served in Kuwait and Iraq and is the older brother of math teacher Miss Taylor on the Seven Oak team.
Lance Corporal Jason Leib served in the Marines. He teaches social studies on the Eight Oak team.
William Whitney Sr. served in the U.S. Army and worked in communications. He served in France during World War II. He is the grandfather of Miss Whitney, Seven Oak science teacher. Army Captain Donald B. Toth served his country as a pilot and aircraft maintenance officer. He is the uncle of Donald Terry Toth, JTL computer teacher.
Second Lieutenant Doug Toth, nephew of Mr. Toth, currently serves in the Army National Guard.
Marine Corporal Andrew C. Schneider is the son of Mr. Schneider, a Six Oak science teacher. Andrew is an active duty F-18 technician currently stationed in Japan.
Gene Hargreaves served in the U.S. Navy during World War II. He's Mrs. Hargreaves' husband's grandfather.
Neil Hargrave is Mrs. Hargrave's father-in-law. He served our country during the Vietnam War.
Mike Hargrave, Mrs. Hargrave's brother-in-law, served our country in the U.S. Navy during the Global War on Terrorism. Ms. Fisher, 8 Oak science teacher, served in the Navy from 1991 through 1996. She attended the Navy Corpsman School in San Diego.
Brian Ferris served in the U.S. Army. He is the father-in-law of Mr. LaBar. Ron LaBar served in the U.S. Army. He is the brother of Mr. LaBar, 7 Oak social studies teacher.
Norman Marsh served in the U.S. Army. He is Mr. LaBar's stepfather.
Carl LaBar served in the U.S. Army. He is the father of Mr. LaBar, 7th grade social studies teacher.
Army Lieutenant Alfred A. Ostrowski served in the Korean War and was a seaman as a merchant marine in World War II. He is the father-in-law of Special Education Supervisor Mrs. Dina Ostrowski. Petty Officer Jeff Yeo is the brother of 6th Birch teacher Mrs. Neely and served in the United States Navy.
Paratrooper in the 101st Screaming Eagle Airborne, James Monty is the father of 6th Birch teacher Mrs. Neely.
Joseph McHugh served with the Marines. He is the husband of Mrs. McHugh.
William J. Kane served in Korea with the 101st Airborne Division. He was a Green Beret. He is the father of Mrs. McHugh. George Shimishko served in the Army for 3 tours in Vietnam. He is the father of Mrs. Conkle, JTL Assistant Principal.
Staff Sergeant Michael Steigerwall is the father of Ray Lenhart, JTL Principal.
Erin Rena Exner is the grandmother of Ray Lenhart, JTL Principal.
Senior Master Sergeant Ronald Exner is the grandfather of Ray Lenhart, JTL Principal. Bridget Neely is the sister of Dr. Greenwood and served in the Air Force.
Shannon Neely is a retired Master Sergeant in the Air Force and the brother-in-law of Dr. Greenwood.
Army Sergeant Terry Dyer served 3 years in Korea from 1965 to 1968. He is the father of Dr. Greenwood.
Robert Mills earned the Purple Heart after serving in the Army during World War II. He was the grandfather of Mrs. Turgeon.
From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Between homerooms has been heating up, and all the money raised will go to an organization called Warrior Strong. Today, we have Mr. Tyson with us, the president of Warrior Strong Incorporated, to tell us a little bit about how the money we raise will help the organization. Please welcome Mr. Tyson.
To organizing Penny Awards this year, I was really glad we brought this fundraiser back This is one of our biggest fundraisers, and obviously it's going to a great cause with Warrior Strong. But I'd like to thank our student council advisors, Mrs. Petcha and Mrs. West, for organizing it. And I'd also like to thank NJHS advisors, Mrs. Rule and Mrs. Gilmore. They will be helping counting the hundreds of pounds of coins, hopefully, that we have over the next couple of weeks when we declare a homeroom winner. Pasquale Marchese, thank you very much for doing everything in the booth today. And also, you probably have not seen her, but I'd like to thank Taylor Carey also for helping out behind the scenes today and getting all that lighting done for us. To our two MCs today, Nolan McAllister and Maya Liniac, thank you very much. You two are awesome. To our teachers and our students today, thank you very much for being here and learning about Veterans Day. I think this is an important day. It's great that we have school and we are able to celebrate this to give you a little background. To our staff that presented today, thank you. I'm moved in a big way. Hearing all of you speak, having worked with you for many, many years, it means a lot that you're willing to share your experiences, and thank you for doing that. I think the big question today is, as students, what have you learned? And it can really be summed up in five very simple words. Anytime you see a veteran, they're wearing a hat, they're wearing a jacket, remember to say these five words to them. Thank you for your service. It's that simple. Soldiers spend an awful lot of time away from home, away from family. They're displaced. They can't be with their family at home when they would like to be. And that is oftentimes a very big struggle. It's a struggle for the families that miss them while they're gone. You need to understand the sacrifice. People join the service and sometimes don't come home. So this is a very big deal that we're able to celebrate them today, but we should be doing it every day. So the next time you see a veteran, please repeat after me. Thank you for your service. Would our veterans please stand? Would you turn around to our students? One, two, three.
Thank you.